this how-to, I'm going to show you how to save specific settings for specific aircraft so you can reuse those settings over and over and over again in flight plan. We won't need flight plan to start out with, so let's open up world map and let's just create a flight. Need something with a lot of thingamajigs and doohickeys, like my grandmother used to say. Beechcraft's a good one. I could probably use one of the commercial jets, but that's kind of overwhelming. Let's adjust our daytime here in the States, and let's take off from Telluride. Why not? We want to start cold and dark, so let's zoom in to Telluride, and let's pick a parking spot. Parking spot one. For our arrival, thought I saw one up here. Yeah, Aspen. I'm gonna leave this flight plan as is and just load it up in Flight Simulator. Okay, and we've spawned in the Beechcraft King Air, cold and dark, in parking spot one at Telluride Regional, ready to start up the aircraft. Let's do our before starting checklist. Okay, so we've got our parking brake set, power levels are at idle, prop levers to max, condition levers to fuel cutoff, and we turn on our battery switch. And it looks like we've already got a half a tank of fuel. You'll want to make sure you either put some fuel before you try and start up here, or you can add fuel in flight plan. So let's go ahead and save this as is. So if you hit escape on your keyboard, go to load save, save to this PC, and then I'm gonna create a new folder. I did not save cold and dark, but that's pretty easy to accomplish if that's what you want. Just start up at any parking spot in world map and you'll start cold and dark. And then let me go back to my main menu and we'll go ahead and open up flight plan. We'll open up that file. And we've loaded the flight plan that we just saved out of world map, and it includes the climb, cruise, descent, and approach with our starting and ending airports and the Beechcraft already selected. If we check our fuel tanks, they're half full or half empty if you're a pessimist. And our first flight state is pre-flight pushback because we're at a parking spot. So those are basically the key elements of where your aircraft spawns. So let's go back into the cockpit and then let's go ahead and just pick something entirely different so you can see I'm not cheating, and we'll reset our flight plan and then we'll reload our flight plan. So we've still got the same flight plan we started with. Now, flight plan actually adds the additional little leg here of showing the parking in addition to your requested takeoff runway. I don't think we requested anything at the destination. It's just got us coming in on the most convenient runway. So let's go ahead and load it up. We've entered our cockpit at parking space one in Telluride with everything turned on, ready to start. So let's go ahead and start up our engines. Right starter, wait for 12% N1. Set fuel cutoff to low idle. Wait for 50% N1. Set it to high idle. We can turn on our generator, turn off our starter, left engine. low idle, 50% high idle. Generator on, starter off. So that gets us started. Let's take it one step farther and set our lights. So I want my landing lights on, taxi lights on, nav lights on. I don't think I need recognition, beacon and strobe we do want. Don't need any of my anti-ice. It's a lovely day here in Telluride. Pitot heat off, and we'll turn on our avionics. And now we're ready to call ATC and taxi out to wherever we want to go. But the point of this video was not to show you how to start up the Beechcraft. The point was to take this Beechcraft in this exact state and put it anywhere I want to put it. Let's take it even one step further, and we'll set our CDI to GPS, and let's set something convenience related, I guess, the wind speed indicator, because I'm fairly sure not all of the settings in the glass cockpit is going to get saved in the flight file. Flight plan will preserve whatever's there, but not every aircraft will save every single switch setting. Like, for example, I think there's some stuff up here. Well, those are the dimmers. The dimmers will save. I'm not sure off the top of my head, but there are some occasional non-critical switch settings that may not save. But if you get in the cockpit, set all of your knob switches and levers to where you want them, and then save from here in the cockpit by hitting escape, load save, save to this PC. We'll go to our King Air directory. This one's ready to taxi. And then let's go ahead and exit out of that flight, and I'll show you the whole point behind doing that. Now remember the previous flight plan, ready to start, same flight plan, but when we spawned in the aircraft, it was not cold and dark. It was with the battery on and the levers in the proper position for me to begin the startup procedure. Now we're going to go to ready to taxi, which is after the startup procedure, plus we've set our lights, plus we made a couple little changes in the glass cockpit, which I'm not entirely sure are going to save, but that's what we want to find out. So now let's go ahead and change this flight plan to something completely different. I don't feel like looking up iCal code. You can see our other videos if you want to see how to Google an iCal code, but I happen to know Portland's KPDX. So we'll just use Portland as our departure. I wonder if they're marked. We might be able to pick a parking spot too if the tarmac is marked. Oh yeah, they are. E5, E6. So we'll try E5. So let me drop a pin. Well, I guess we might as well drop it right on E5 here. Right there, KPDX. Again, I just happen to know that, but you could open a browser and Google it quickly enough. If you're not certain of the runway, leave it at zero, and Flight Simulator will spawn you at the elevation on the ground. We won't need Telluride anymore. And let's land at San Francisco, which is KSFO. And is right on that little peninsula, I believe. Nope, a little south of it. And it's our arrival. We don't really care. I guess we can pick a runway. Let's create our push pin first. Okay, and I like to drop my push pin in the middle of my arrival runway just so that the glass cockpit GPS leads me to the center of it. So this is KSFO, also an airport. Okay, and then we don't need any of the rest of this original flight plan, and we'll save this one. And just to polish up our flight plan a little bit, we said we wanted E5. Now, this may or may not work because sometimes the actual gate nomenclature can be a little different. I don't know that I've seen E_5, but I think I've seen like E-5 and some without. The way to be sure is to go save a flight plan at Portland, parked at a spot, and then you'll know for sure. There could also be a suffix if it's medium, heavy, small, whatever. But in this case, we're starting at E5. I've already forgotten where we wanted to take off. So we will, this would be a perfect runway, head us straight for San Francisco off of a closed runway. We're not gonna use that one. So take off along the river here, 28 right. One 9 left, and you can request a gate, and oftentimes you'll get that gate. I'm still on the ground. My latitude and longitude should be set at my parking spot. Did I move my push pin? Yes. Yeah, we'll pick up some donuts at the Blue Star Donuts on the way out. Perfect. This one's ready to go. actually, I may need more fuel. Let's go ahead and fill all our tanks. Now, obviously, you would want to calculate the exact fuel that you need. For flying for fun, you can just fill it up 100%. And then we'll go back in to world map. I'm going to reset world map to make sure that it unloads any settings it was trying to hold for me from previous flight plans. Now we'll load our King Air, KPDX to KSFO, ready to taxi. Oh, and you can see I didn't actually need all that fuel. A half tank probably would have been pretty close. So there we are, spawned exactly where we wanted to be, right on the X. Except I forgot to set my heading. But you can see we're ready to pick up some donuts and take off. Our aircraft is started. It looks like it saved both my wind setting and my GPS setting in my glass cockpit. My landing lights are on. It didn't save my taxi lights. I guess because I'm at pre-flight pushback, it may have turned my taxi lights off. I've never checked that before, but my beacon and strobe are on. My levers are where I left them, which really, I should have set them at low idle first, I think. Now you're ready to take off. So if you want to create flight plans with your aircraft in a particular configuration, somewhere between cold and dark and ready to take off, then you can set all your knob switches and dials, save from within the cockpit, and just reuse that flight plan as many times as you want in as many different airports as you want. And of course, I could add other waypoints between here and there. I could fly by Mount Hood or Mount Rainier or whatever. I think Mount Hood's right here. Drop a pin on Mount Hood, and then you can visit Mount Hood on your way to San Francisco. Well, that was kind of a lousy spot. That's how to save the specific settings by aircraft for each aircraft. Again, the caveats to this are going to be certain switch settings just won't save for particular aircraft. I've also not gone back and tried some of the older aircraft like the Beaver or the DC-3. Should work because all those switch settings need to be set, but I don't know how many of those switch settings Flight Simulator will save to a flight plan. Whereas here in a modern aircraft like the Beechcraft, when you save from the cockpit, all your doodads and thingamajigs are all set where they need to be, or at least where you wanted them, and then you can change that flight plan as many times as you want. Hope this was helpful. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe.